most often, the other ones are taken most often, they just are often the supermen, that's a bad time. It just looks fantastic. I hope that they come to become architects or fashion designers or something. Kids and books. These have changed over the past few years. Far from that. I can't believe that in the past we used to have those awful lane controllers with no sensitivity. No wonder my thumb snapped on my wrist like last year. It's got much better. And before we move on to the hardware, I'd say that from a game design perspective, our learnings have been simple things like the stop menus. Being able to just get the same button repeatedly when you get into the game is a really huge deal. And again, it's not much fun watching kids cry when that goes wrong. But if you just think about it, it's so easy. Play. There can be all of the other options you want. Just having a kid be able to press a button and get it is great. User interfaces. There was a gentleman earlier who was going through Magic and Dust, which was excellent. And I can only remember how he said it. User interface is so important. They're really easy to do if you just think about it. I'm a programmer, I'm a game designer, and I will say I'm guilty as the guy in the grassy knoll when it comes to doing bad interfaces. I totally understand where it's coming from, and it really took me until I had kids to realize how to do it right. I would recommend focus groups. That's huge when it comes to user interfaces. So when it comes to hardware, it's probably no accident that when we've had the rise of girls and younger kids getting into gaming, that the DS became the best summer platform by a huge margin. The DS and the Wii, by the way, are just absolutely turning their industry on its head. I saw a public statement the other day that this year they accounted for 45% of all game sales. It's amazing. Absolutely amazing. And with the install base going up, that's likely to increase next year. And credit to them, it's all about the game they took on user interfaces. You know, a small kid has to find something a lot easier just to touch something with stylus or their finger than they do with buttons. Tilt and move, I spoke a little bit about the six-axis controller and the Wii. These have really helped change our industry. And, you know, I would just applaud Sony for their six-axis controller. I know it hasn't got as much press as the Wii, but actually it really is a good platform for making kids' games. And not what we should be talking about. Or standing. This is the Wii Fit board. And you can expect from EA to see a lot more kids' games using this. That's a pretty easy control mechanism. You stand on it, and you can balance. Kids can do it, and they can do it well, and they can often do it better than their parents, which is always something that's nice. And in addition to the iPhone, PCs, I think that for a long time, the PC market has been slightly in disarray. You may have noticed that sales have been kind of chunking down, and as people have started to enjoy online entertainment, but touch is really turning things around. And PCs, my guess is that PC touch-based laptops are going to spur a renaissance in PC gaming and PC sales over the next few years. So that's my top tech tip. I would invest in that. Kids love physics. Here's a PC game that has proven extremely popular, and it looks like a spreadsheet. But it's something that was built by a university, and it's literally you make little blocks and all the physics actually works. There's some kind of hardware or spatial understanding that young kids have that makes them love this stuff. So they love making these creations, applying pressure, watching them fall down, watching them move around. It's a little bit of what they enjoyed in Boom Blocks, and this goes a step further. You can make so many different contraptions with this thing. It's excellent. And I would expect physics games again to increase and increase and increase, particularly the emphasis on touch. The next big change that's occurred is where does kids' IQ come from? I alluded to it slightly earlier. That's our Harry Potter range that we make the games with. But kids' IQ, more and more, is its source can be any of those areas. And I would say that games are going to take a larger chunk in terms of the IP creation, but not a larger chunk as a percentage of the overall landscape. So I think that as you will you'll eventually see things like video game toys and video game movies and books being as important, for example, as the way comic books have provided a spur for intellectual property in the movie business over the past few years. Books, I am convinced, will remain a very, very significant player, as with toys, 2D movies. But games are a new IP generator in the universe. It's going to be fascinating to see